Assalamu alaikum, how are you guys doing? Today we are going to be talking about cardio and whether or not it burns your muscles. That is, many in the fitness space will tell you to avoid cardio as they say that it will come in the way of you making muscle gains. Is this really true? Well, if you want to find out, then you want to stick to the end of the video. And make sure to drop a like on the video as well and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. So before we answer the question of whether cardio burns muscle or not, let's first talk about some of the benefits of doing cardio, even whilst you are trying to build muscle. To begin with, cardio actually helps with muscle recovery. And this is because it increases blood flow into the muscles and removes waste products, which overall helps with a quicker muscle recovery period. Another benefit of doing cardio while you're trying to build muscle is that it ensures that your conditioning and your stamina is on point. You don't want to be that big guy in the gym who can't even walk up the bloody stairs, or you're going up or down a hill and you're already out of breath after like 10-20 seconds. And I'm sure you know guys like that, and you don't want to be like that. You want to make sure that you are truly physically fit, including with your stamina as well. And a lot of these guys who don't ever do cardio, sometimes they will do cardio, or specifically they will do cardio only when they're cutting, when they're trying to lose fat. But when they're trying to build muscle, which is most of the year, they will do no cardio. And when you're, if you're going to do that, then once you do start doing cardio, when you're trying to lose fat, when you're trying to cut, then imagine how hard it's going to be, how uncomfortable it's going to be, because you're going to be so out of practice. And then more important than helping with your muscle recovery, and more important than helping with your stamina and conditioning, is the fact that cardio is healthy. It strengthens your heart as it pumps more blood throughout the body. And on top of that, many studies go to show that doing cardio can prolong your life even. Of course, Qadar Allah, Allah decides how long we live and, you know, when we go. But there's no doubt means that we can also take, and doing cardio is one of them. And now in regard to any potential drawbacks, if and when can cardio possibly come in the way of stopping you from building muscle? The first potential problem that you could have when you're trying to build muscle and you're doing cardio is that of calorie consumption. And by that, here's what I mean. To build muscle, you should be eating in a slight caloric surplus, which means you want to be eating more calories than you burn per day. Opposite to what you want to be doing when you're trying to lose weight, which is what? Which is a caloric deficit, where you actually burn more calories than you eat per day. But now you're trying to eat more calories than you're burning per day. So of course, doing cardio will increase how many calories you are burning per day, which means that now you have to eat more to be in a caloric surplus. And this could particularly be a problem for hard gainers. Hard gainers are people who find it hard to gain muscle, because they are what's known as ectomorphs, meaning they're naturally skinny people who have a very fast metabolism. So in other words, they already have to eat so much food to build muscle. And so now they're doing cardio on top, they're gonna have to eat even more food to build muscle. But the truth is that as long as you're eating back those calories, you should be fine. When you are starting to go on a bulk and trying to build muscle, you should of course factor in how much exercise you're gonna be doing, both your weightlifting and your cardio. And based on that, you should then assign yourself calories. And so if you do that from the beginning, you should be good to go. And if you do need to increase calories as time goes on, then that is fine as well. So the problem really is just one of convenience. Like, how many calories are you really going to be adding onto your diet? But of course, that is going to depend on how much cardio you're doing. And as long as you're not doing too much, I'm guessing you're not like a marathon runner or something, then you should probably be good to go. The other issue that people usually bring up is that of cardio breaking down muscle tissues and damaging your muscles and stuff like this. To be honest, I think that a lot of the times people exaggerate about this, but the truth is that as long as you're not doing excess cardio, you're not doing too much, I'd say like once a week, I would say you should do, because of the health benefits, and like twice and thrice should be fine too. But if you go to start doing it every single day, or if you're going on like 2 hour, you know, marathons and stuff like this, then yeah, this could potentially be a problem. But I'm guessing that you're not no Mo Farah kind of guy, so it should probably be all fine. Speaking of Mo Farah, it's kind of funny, some people, they try to give the example of Mo Farah, oh look at him, he does cardio and he's so skinny, and so therefore if you do cardio you're going to be skinny, which is a horrendous kind of way of putting it. It's just false, Number one, I don't think you're going to be doing marathons. If you are, okay, sure, great. You should take that into account. But secondly, Mo Farah doesn't care about building muscle. I'm pretty sure he does not care about building muscle. I'm sure my man's not going ham on his deadlifts and his squats. So I don't really think that's applicable. If you want to build muscle, you have to make sure that you're in a slight caloric surplus, meaning eating a bit more than you're burning per day. You also, of course, want to weightlift consistently, and you want to eat a good amount of protein. If you're doing these things, then adding in cardio probably is not going to have a negative impact on your muscle gain.